A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video.
We often talked about China's space ambitions on this channel, and this, of course, prompted quite some hilarious comments. But why do we even talk about the Chinese space program?
Well, because apart from SpaceX and NASA, we think the only space program that is capable of landing humans on the moon and even building a moon base is the Chinese one. And they are actually not even secretive about it. So let's take a more detailed look at China's moon base plans and how they would want to pull this off.
It's not secret that China has strong moon ambitions. Not only has China successfully conducted the first moon rock sample return mission since 1976, just recently, with the Chang'e 5, bringing back moon rocks to Earth on December 16, 2020. This was the latest in the line of successful Chang'e missions. The Chang'e 4 mission had the first lander and rover on the far side of the moon on the 3rd of January 2019. And the small rover U22 is, by the way, still roaming around on the lunar far side. The previous Chinese moon missions also were all successes. Chang'e 3 landed on the moon already back in December 2013, and this was the first time when China employed a moon rover. So the history of China's moon successes is quite impressive. But of course, China has much bigger plans for the moon, because they want to land humans on the moon by around 2030. And not only that, but they immediately want to start building a moon base around that time. So how will the Chinese moon base look like? And how do they want to build it? Luckily, the Chinese space agency CNSA and the Chinese Lunar Exploration Program branch of that agency CLEP have released quite some information over the years. First, we know from a conference in Beijing from September last year that China wants to take a twofold approach for the moon landings.
They will build two moon rockets, a smaller one which looks like a Chinese version of Falcon Heavy, and a large super heavy lift rocket, the Long March 9. The smaller rocket is still unnamed and it will land the taikonauts on the moon. Taikonauts is the name for the Chinese astronauts. So they showed a few interesting slides at said conference in September last year of how they are going to pull this off. The unnamed Chinese moon rocket will bring a moon lander to the moon, which will land very similarly to how it was done in the Apollo missions. On this slide here, we get a clearer picture of the additional hardware involved. On the left is this new Chinese Falcon Heavy we mentioned. Second from the left is the Red Dragon capsule, as we like to call it. This new deep space capsule already exists and has been successfully tested. It's like a Chinese version of Crew Dragon, that's why we like to call it Red Dragon. In the middle we see part of the moon lander architecture with a landing stage and transfer stage. We assume that it is a modular lander, so it is shown without the crew cabin on this slide. Then the second from the right is also interesting. This would be the Chinese analog to the lunar gateway. We see a power module with two large solar arrays, a habitation module, and an attached Red Dragon capsule. So China also wants to have some kind of lunar gateway of their own. And then on the right, we have a pressurized rover. Having a pressurized rover on the moon is really an excellent idea, and we know that NASA has very similar plans for pressurized rovers of their own, which actually already have been tested way back in the days of the Constellation program. And actually, there were plans for pressurized lunar rovers even in the days of Apollo. And if you want to support our YouTube channel and help us to continue talking about all kinds of disruptive technologies, then please check out our favorite online learning platform, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions of people come together to take the next step in their creative journey. With thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including programming, illustration, design, and so many more.
And what better way to start a new year by learning about how to improve your personal finances in the course Modern Money Habits, 5 Steps to Build the Life You Want. In this new class, Justin Bridges shares the simple 5-step approach that allowed him to leave a career on Wall Street to launch his own photography business, packed with the actionable tips and straightforward examples that have made Justin's photo classes a hit with more than 80,000 Skillshare students. This 70-minute class will guide you through every step of creating a personalized plan to take charge of your financial destiny. The best value for money would be the annual subscription at less than $10 a month. And if you use our special link here, you would even get a free trial of the Skillshare Premium membership. So be sure to use our special link, join Skillshare today, and start to learn anything you like, from home or anywhere you prefer. But so much for the hardware of the moon landings themselves. Interestingly, this does not yet tell anything about a moon base, but we do know that China has plans to build a moon base because they have mentioned it on multiple occasions and have some nice renderings and animations of it. One render we have shown a few times already is this one here, which is an official render of CNSA from a few years back. You can see several interesting items here. First, you can see that the moon base is of modular design, with three habitation modules attached to each other. You can see three large solar arrays vertically erected to receive as much sunlight as possible from the low sun, because we assume that the station will be built near the lunar south pole, where we have the largest water ice reserves. Then you can also see two pressurized rovers attached to the base, and another pressurized rover is here to the right. Taikonaut suits are attached in the back so that they can get into the suit directly from the rover and vice versa. You can see another habitation module having been landed with a larger cargo lander in the background on a previously constructed landing pad. We also see an additional smaller base here on the right in the back with one habitat module, and then two radio telescope dishes to the right of that base. We have two other devices here of which we don't know the function, but they could be either related to propellant production or some scientific instrument in order to conduct experiments on the moon. It could also be an oxygen extraction device, which would extract oxygen from lunar regolith, because 40 to 45% of lunar regolith is oxygen, believe it or not. And oxygen could actually be quite easily extracted from the regolith. In one method, for example, the regolith is placed in a mesh-lined basket. Calcium chloride, the electrolyte, is added, and the mix is heated to around 950 degrees Celsius, a temperature that doesn't melt the material. Then an electrical current is applied, which in this case would be obtained from the solar arrays or a radiothermal electric generator. This extracts the oxygen and migrates the salt to an anode, where it can be easily removed.
Another method has been proposed by an aerospace engineer called Thorsten Denk, which we find even better. He presented this method at the 23rd annual Solar Paces conference in Chile in 2017. His process uses ilmenite, an iron oxide found in the dark mare regions of the moon. It would be dug up by a small robot and carried to the reactor. To remove the oxygen, you add hydrogen so it becomes water. H2O comes out of the first step. So you have iron titanium trioxide plus H2O plus solar heat gives iron plus titanium dioxide plus H2O. The second step is in an electrolyzer using the product water from the reactor. The water split to produce hydrogen and oxygen. So H2O plus electric energy gives H2 plus a half O2. The oxygen is the product and the hydrogen gets returned to the process. So this would enable us to get everything solely from lunar regolith plus solar power. One such machine could produce 2.5 kilograms of oxygen in 4 hours. The chemical reaction is mostly powered by the solar reactor and would use less than 5 kilowatts of electricity. So in theory, we wouldn't necessarily need the water ice deposits at the lunar south pole, because ilmenite from lunar regolith would suffice. But water ice certainly would make life a lot easier, of course, as water would be directly present and it can be easily split it into hydrogen and oxygen. So all we need on the moon: water and oxygen for human life support, and hydrogen and oxygen for rocket fuel.
The lunar south pole also has the advantage of eternal sunlight, and not 28 days of day or night, which wouldn't be so nice as you can imagine. Anyways, back to the Chinese moon base. So this was one render that we were shown, but another short animation has been going around, giving us a more detailed glimpse of the modular moon base. In this animation, the moon base has a bit of a different layout. We have 4 habitat modules instead of 3. On the inside, you can see quite some comfortable living space for the taikonaut. But unfortunately, more details aren't shown. This moonbase here will be named Yuegong or Moon Palace. And in order to test the moonbase, the Chinese already conducted a long-term stay in a simulated moonbase in Beijing. A few Chinese student volunteers stayed aboard the Lunar Palace 1, as this mockup was named, for a whole year, from May 2017 to May 2018. The Lunar Palace 1 moonbase mockup occupies a 160 square meter or 500 cubic meter self-contained laboratory composed of a 58 square meter vegetation area of two modules, a 42 square meter living area with three bedrooms, dining room, bathroom, and waste disposal chamber. The lab was designed by Liu Hong from the Beijing University of Aeronautics and Astronautics. So the moonbase mockup is a type of bioregenerative life support system, the third built in the world and the first one in China. With a crew of three, 55% of the food consumed was produced internally, balanced by reserves. Then oxygen was regenerated through the vegetation compartment, and water was recycled internally. The crew's waste was all composted. After 1 year, this moonbase experiment ended and was a full success.
So we see that China is already training or trying to gain some experience of how living on the moon would look like and how to make the moonbase more self-sufficient by utilizing plants and recycling everything as best as possible. The Chinese moonbase modules will be brought to the moon by the Long March 9 heavy lift rocket, which is currently also under development. The new unnamed moon rocket will bring the taikonauts to the moon, while the Long March 9 will bring the heavy cargo to the moon, such as the habitat modules, pressurized rovers, and power systems. The Long March 9 is a real beast with 130 metric tons of payload to low Earth orbit, 50 metric tons to translunar injection, or 44 metric tons to Mars. You could basically call it a Chinese Saturn V. It will be, when finished, by far the most powerful rocket China has ever built. The current designs we often see for this rocket vary quite a lot, so we'll have to wait and see how the final designs will be. So yes, China has set its eyes on the moon, and by 2030, we should see the first Chinese taikonauts on the moon. With the Artemis program also aiming to build a moon base in the late 2020s, and with SpaceX possibly participating in the efforts to build a moon base, or maybe even attempting to build a moon base of their own, it could be a very interesting time on the moon in 10 years. One thing is certain though, the US shouldn't underestimate China, because even though their approach is not extremely fast, their track record has been excellent until now, and it wouldn't be good for the US to leave the moon completely to China. As it appears now, China might even get help from Russia, as Dmitry Rogozin has said quite a few times in the past that the Russian space agency is reorienting itself more towards a cooperation with China. So a coordinated moon effort between China and Russia is very possible. So of course, we want to wish you all a happy new year. It certainly can only get better than 2020. And we are looking forward to bring you more space and disruption reports in 2021.
So thanks for watching the first JI Space Report in 2021. And I would say, on to the future.
We're now with full of motivation, right?
Bitte.
And we are looking forward. And we are looking forward to what?